Hello all of you. Today we will see image formation by convex lens and its uses. Only two cases are there. First one is object is at infinite. So convex lens, pole, center of curvature, principal axis, parallel rays to principal axis. After reflection will diverge from focus. Will diverge from focus. Okay, appear to diverge from focus. It means if we extend these two rays back, they will meet at focus F. Okay. So whenever object is at infinite, image will be produced at principal focus behind the mirror. Okay, at focus. Behind the mirror, it will be highly diminished. It will be virtual and erect. Okay, highly diminished means point-like, so it will be very small in size compared to object. Okay, so object at infinite, image will be formed at focus, and it will be behind the mirror, so it will be virtual and erect, and it will be highly diminished. That is point-like. Okay, so this you have to remember. Whenever object is at infinite, rays coming from object will be parallel to each other. And in our case, we will take them parallel to principal axis also. Okay, so parallel rays after reflection from convex mirror will appear to diverge from focus. That is the rule. So that we have applied here. And second case is object is between infinity and pole. So at any distance between pole and infinite where object is placed, okay, so again pole, center of curvature, principal axis, principal focus. Now we can draw object anywhere. So a dash b dash is the object. So we will take parallel ray to principal axis. So after reflection it will appear to diverge from focus. Okay, so like this we can draw. Second ray directed towards center of curvature, it will reflect back along the same path. And third one passing through pole, it will get reflected with the same angle of incidence, and we can extend it back. So meeting point of all these three rays will give us image of A dash. Then we have to draw foot of perpendicular, which will give B dash. So A dash B dash will be image of the object. Okay, so instead of three rays you have to select only two, any two you can use. Okay, one is parallel to principal axis, so after reflection it will diverge or appear to diverge from focus. Second is directed towards center of curvature, so it will get reflected back along the same path. And third is directed towards pole, so it will obey the law of reflection, so it will be reflected with same angle as incidence angle. Okay, then we have to extend it back, so it will meet at point A dash. These all three, so there the image of A will be formed, that is A dash. Then drop foot of perpendicular on principal axis, that will give B dash. So A dash B dash is image of AB. Okay, so now you can see that image is obtained between pole and principal focus behind the mirror. So image is formed between pole and focus and behind the mirror. You can see it is erect, so virtual and erect, because rays are not really meeting, they are appearing to meet, so it is virtual image. And you can see it is erect one. Okay, and it is smaller in size, so diminished one, so image will be diminished. Now we have to remember that in case of convex mirror, image formed will be always diminished. That is first point. In both the case it is diminished. Second point is image formed will be between pole, and it can form till focus. So from pole till principal focus image can be formed. So image cannot be formed beyond F. Okay, maximum it can be formed at F, or it will be at less distance than F. Okay, so either it will be between F and P, or it will be at F. Okay, this is the second thing we have to remember. So image formed will be always diminished, first point. Second point, image formed will be between P and F, or maximum it can be at F. And third point, image formed will be always virtual and direct. Okay, so these three points we have to remember for the image formed by convex mirror. So two cases are there in this table. So you can view this table as we have discussed early. Okay, same things are written here. Now uses of convex mirror. So this is first use in as a rear view mirror. Okay, why it is used as rear view mirror? Because it has larger field of view. Okay, what is field of view? That we will see in one or two slide later. So actually field of view means the area covered by the mirror. So how much area we can see by this mirror, that is called field of view. So for convex mirror, as it is bulgy, so more area we can see in this mirror, so it is used as rear view mirror. Then in some parking slots it can be used, okay, so to see anything is coming or not. Okay, you can check the image. Then in malls it can be used for security purpose, so everything can be viewed from this mirror. That is the example here you can see. So lady which is standing can see this person and this person. So this lady which is standing here can view this person and this person, all the three. Okay, because here is a convex mirror. So field of view is large, means the person which is standing here can also be seen, or here can also be seen. Okay. So these are the uses. You can check this one, why it is so. Okay, so what is wider field of view? That we will see here. So plane mirror, and this is convex mirror. Okay, so plane mirror we can see this much part only if we extend this, so this much area we can see. Okay, but where in case of convex mirror, this is convex mirror, so the area which we can see will be greater than it. So here you can imagine an object here. O is the object in both the case. So from object, the rays which are reflected by the mirror, so in first case they will be reflected less, in second case they will be reflected at higher angle. Okay, because angle of incidence will be more, so field of view will be large. So field of view in this case will be this much larger area. Okay, so field of view means portion or the area that can be seen through the mirror. So in case of convex mirror, as it is bulgy, the reflecting surface is bulgy outward. Okay, so the field of view will be more. Okay, so again, field of view means area which can be seen in the mirror, that is called field of view of the mirror. Okay, so if you keep plane mirror and convex mirror nearby, so you can see larger area through convex mirror compared to plane mirror. Okay, so if plane mirror and convex mirror are given, if you want to see a distant tall building through both, then it is fixed that we can view full building through convex mirror, because it will cover larger area compared to plane mirror. So we will keep till this in this video.